Bruckner, the government's position is this. There are several million dollars in the pipeline, five to be exact, for which we have received some $55 million worth of requests, all the way from the doctor in North Dakota who desires to study the semen of pigs, to the health reporter on Long Island who is convinced this is being transmitted by dogs, and the reason so many gay men have contracted it is because they have so many dogs.
$5 million doesn't seem quite right for some 2,000 cases. The government spent $20 million investigating 7 deaths from Tylenol. We are now almost into the 3rd year of this epidemic.
Unfortunately, the president has threatened to veto. As you know, he has gone on record as being unalterably and irrevocably opposed to anything that might be construed as an endorsement of homosexuality. Naturally, this has slowed things down.
Naturally. It looks as if we've got a pretty successful stalemate going on here, doesn't it?
Well, that's not what we're here to discuss today, is it?
I don't think I'm going to like hearing what I think I'm about to hear. But go ahead, at your own peril.
We have decided to reject your application for funding.
I would like to hear your reasons.
We felt the direction of your thinking was imprecise and unfocused.
Could you be a little more precise?
I beg your pardon.
You don't know what's going on any more than I do. My guess is as good as anybody's. Why are you blocking my efforts?
Dr. Bruckner, since you first became involved with this, and we pay tribute to you as a pioneer, one of the few courageous pioneers, there have been other investigators. Quite frankly, Doctor, this is no longer just your disease, though you seem to think it is.
Oh, I do. Do I? And you're here to take it away from me, is that it? Well, I'll let you in on a little secret, Doctor. You can have it. I didn't want it in the first place. Do you think it's my privilege to have the good fortune of watching young men die? What's the use? What am I arguing with you for? You don't know enough medicine to treat a mouse. You don't know enough science to study boiled water. How dare you come and judge me?
We only serve on this panel at the behest of Dr. Yost.
Another idiot. And, by the way, a closeted homosexual who is doing everything in his power to sweep this under the rug. And I vowed I'd never say that in public. How is it that all the idiots are always on your team? You guys have all the money, call all the shots, shut everybody out, and then operate behind closed doors. I am taking care of more victims of this epidemic than anyone in the world. We have more accumulated test results, more frozen blood samples, more data, more experience. How can you not fund my research or invite me to participate in yours? A promising virus has already been discovered in France. Why are we being told not to cooperate with the French? Why are you refusing to cooperate with the French? Just so you can steal a Nobel Prize. Your National Institutes of Health received my first request for research money 2 years ago. It took you 1 year to print up application forms. It's taken you 2.5 years for my first reported case just to show up here and take a look. The paltry amount of money you are making us beg for, and the $4 billion you are given each and every year, won't come to anyone until only God knows when. Anyway, you add this all up, it is an unconscionable delay and has never, ever existed in any other health emergency during this entire century, while something is being passed around that causes death. We are enduring an epidemic of death. Women have been discovered to have it in Africa, where it is clearly transmitted heterosexually. It is only a question of time. We could all be dead before you do anything. You want my patients? Take them. Take them! Just do something for them! You're fucking right! I'm imprecise and unfocused! And you are all idiots!
This is perfect for our new offices. The room upstairs is just as big, and it's cheap.
How come you think?
Didn't Tommy tell you? After he found it, he ran into the owner at a gay bar, yeah, who confessed after a few beers that his friend was sick. Did you see us on TV yesterday? Picketing the mayor and all that rain?
Yeah.
How do we look?
All wet.
He's got 4 more hours to go. Our lender threatened that if he didn't meet with us by the end of the day, we'd escalate to civil disobedience. Mel found this huge, straight black guy who trained with Martin Luther King. He's going to teach us how to tie up the bridge and tunnel traffic. Tell Hiram that we're going to bring 3.
And to that, to the council, to bring 2, network 2, task force 2, we 2 patients.
Well, then I'll just go. I mean, what are they going to do, kick me out?
It's too late. I'm afraid the list has already been phoned in. And
already phoned in. Too late. I mean, why is everything so final? How dare you make this decision without me? I wrote that letter. I got 60 gay organizations to sign it. I organized the picketing when the mayor wouldn't respond. That meeting is mine. It's happening because of me. It's taken me 21 months to arrange it. God damn, I'm going to go.
You're not the whole organization, Dad.
What does that mean? What did Tommy tell me?
I told him not to.
Representing this organization that I spent every minute of my life fighting for, that started in my living room or I'd quit.
I told them you probably wouldn't accept their decision.
You would let me quit.
You didn't have to pull forward. If you wanted to take me, you'd take me.
First try to reach you. We'd have saved 2 years. You'll see.
We have over $500,000. The time is finally running out. Why aren't you willing to let me go out there and so fast? Because you're a bully, Ned. The boy doesn't agree with you. You always threaten to quit. You never listen to us. I can't work with you anymore.
And you're straight. Organization that I told everybody would fight for them isn't fighting at all. It's become the gay S.
Yeah, well, maybe that's all it could become, Ned.
Quarantine us or put us in camps.
They will not.
It's
draft of the letter. You're circulating this letter widely among people of judgment and good sense in our community. We take this action to combat your damage brought as far as we can see. You're having no scruples whatsoever. You are on a colossal ego trip that you must curtail. Manipulate fear, as you have done repeatedly in your merchandising of this epidemic, is to us the gesture of barbarism. To exploit the deaths of gay men, as you have done in publications all over America, is to us an act of inexcusable vandalism. And to attempt to justify your outburst of outrageous temper as part of what it means to be Jewish is past our comprehending. And after years of liberation, you have made sex dirty again for us, terrible and forbidden. We are more angry at you than in our lives towards anyone. We think you want to lead us all, but we do not want you to. In accordance with our bylaws drawn up by Weiss, Frank, and Levenstein, Mr. Jennings is hereby removed as the director. We beg that you lead us quietly and not destroy us in what good work we manage despite your disapproval. And in closing, please know that we will always welcome your input, your advice, and your help. I belong to a culture that includes proof. Tchaikovsky, Cold War, Plato, Aristotle, Alexander the Great, Michelangelo, Leonardo da Vinci, Christopher Marlowe, Walt Whitman, and C. Whitman. Ian Forrester, Auden, James Baldwin, Harry Stack Sullivan, John Maynard Keynes, Doc Hammarskjöld. These are my disciplines. Four brothers. Four Frank brothers. Once upon a time, you wanted to be a soldier. Bruce, did you know that an openly gay Englishman was as responsible for winning the Second World War as anybody else? His name was Alan Turing, and he cracked the Germans' Enigma code, so the Allies knew in advance what the Germans were going to do. After the World War, he committed suicide. He was so hounded for being gay. Don't they teach this in school? Then he would have killed himself, and then he wouldn't be so terrified of who you are. The only way we'll have real pride is if we demand recognition of a culture that isn't just sexual. It's all there. All through history we've been there. But we have to claim it and identify it and articulate what's in our mind and our hearts. And until we do that, until we organize ourselves neighborhood by city, by state, into a united physical community that fights back, we're doomed. That's how I want to be identified. That's how I want to be defined. As one of the men that fought the war. Being defined by our gods, literally killing us. Must we be reduced to becoming a home murderer? Why couldn't you and I, Bruce Niles and Ned Weeks, have been leaders in creating a new definition of what it means to be gay?
Nothing like? I bought dinner.
Emma says the cure won't be found until the next century. Emma says still years till a vaccine wouldn't be any good anyway. Emma says that the incubation period could be 3, 10, 20 years.
Emma says that you've got to eat.
Jewish boys think that you can always make everything right. That the world can always be a better place. Did I tell you that the Times is running an editorial this Sunday entitled "The Slow Response"? You're right. I didn't have anything to do.
Why are you doing this? Why are you eating this shit? Twinkies? Potato chips? You're supposed to watch what you eat. You're supposed to eat right.
I have a life expectancy of 10 more minutes. I'll eat what I want to eat. David, who sold you the pig on Bleecker Street, finally died. It took forever. They say that he looked like someone out of Auschwitz. Do you hear me?
No. Are you ready to get up?
No! 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 I've had over 40 treatments. No! I've had two, no, no, three different types of chemo. I've had interferon, a couple of kinds. I've had two different.
salad. No broccoli, we don't want any of that, no sir. No bread with 7 grains. Who would ever want any milk? You might get some calcium in your bones. You want to die, Felix? Die!
Hard on us, isn't it? This kind of love. sooner.
I haven't much, except a beautiful piece of land on the Cape in Wellfleet, on a hill overlooking the Atlantic Ocean. Eddie doesn't know about it. It's meant to have been a surprise. We've been there together.
Listed as the beneficiary, then they must.
But what if they don't?
I assure you, I will fight to see the beneficiary.
I was hoping you'd say that. Could I sign my will now, please? It's like, I don't have time to see you again.
This will be quite legal. We can stop by one of my associate's offices and have it witnessed properly as you sign it.
Little piece of paper is legal? Now, why did you go to law school?
I sometimes wonder. You know, Felix, I think of leaving here too because I don't think anybody is listening to me either. I said all this up as well. I understand the virus has finally been discovered in Washington.
Well, the story is they couldn't find it. So after 15 months, they stole it from the French. Named it. Who knows how many millions of us now exposed. Well, there isn't a good word to be said about anybody's behavior in this whole mess. Could you help me get a taxi? I need to get to the airport.
The airport?
Yes. I'm going to Romania to see their famous woman doctor. A desperation tactic, Tom would call it. Why Bucharest Airlines inspire you with any confidence?
And while we were standing there, side by side,
gathered together in the sight of God to join together these two men. They love each other very much and want to be married in the presence of their family before Felix dies. I can see no objection. This is my hospital, my church. Do you, Felix Turner, take Ned Weeks,
Alexander,
to be your...
my lover?
He always wanted me to take him to your new house in the country. Just for him.
Ned, I'm sorry about Felix and other things.
Why didn't I find Martha? Why didn't I wait at the White House even if nobody else would come here? Or go on a hunger strike? Oh, I forgot to tell him something. There were 600 young men and women there. Smart, exceptional young men and women.
I guess I misjudged love.